Hello, and welcome to the Stardog Academy training on installation and setup. I'm Brendan Newland, one of the solutions architects at Stardog. To let you know a bit more about me, I earned my PhD in the academic study of religions and cultures, then conducted research in leadership development, philanthropy, and the nonprofit sector. In the course of managing research data for these complex topics, I developed proficiency with the R language for programming and data science, and became a graph database developer and knowledge graph enthusiast. Today, I'm going to walk you through Stardog installation and setup. In this training session, you will learn how to install Stardog and Stardog Studio on several types of systems, including installation steps for macOS, Linux, Docker, and Windows. You'll also learn how to start Stardog and Stardog Studio after installation is complete. Let's get started. This section is about the system requirements for installing Stardog. Stardog versions 7.3 and up have been tested on Java versions 8 and 11, and they require sun.misc.unsafe. Note that Stardog does not run on any other versions of Java. To check your version of Java in macOS or Linux, run the following command from the terminal, java-v. To check the version on Windows, open a command prompt and run java-version. You can get Java 8 or 11 from Oracle, or use a version from OpenJDK. Stardog has been verified to run on Ubuntu 16.04 and 18.04, Red Hat version 7, CentOS 7, Amazon Linux 2, recent versions of OS 10, and Microsoft Windows Server 2019. This concludes the section about system requirements. This section is about installation on macOS. The recommended method for installing Stardog on macOS is to use Homebrew. With Homebrew installed, you can open a terminal and run the command brew install stardog-union /tap/stardog. You'll need to set the Stardog home environment variable with export stardog home /var/stardog. If you have a license key, add it to your Stardog home directory or set a Stardog license path environment variable to its location. It's also possible to install manually from the zip file. This section is about installation on Linux. We recommend installing via a package manager for convenience and because using a package manager will ensure that dependencies such as Java are installed if they're not already present. If you use Homebrew, follow the instructions for macOS installation. It's also possible to install manually by using wget to download the zip file. To install Stardog on Debian-based systems using apt-get, run the following commands in a terminal, specifying which version it is you want to install. These will first add the Stardog GPG key to the system, and then fetch and install the Stardog deb package. To install Stardog on RPM-based systems using yum, run the following commands. Certain Amazon EC2 instances do not let you redirect output into /etc/yum.repos.d. as specified above. On such instances, install Stardog using the following commands. This concludes the section about installation on Linux. This section is about installation via Docker. First, install Docker and confirm the Docker daemon is running using Docker version. The latest release of Stardog is available on Docker Hub. Pull the image from Docker Hub with docker pull stardog/stardog:latest. The Stardog home directory is located in /var/opt/stardog in the Docker image. This is the directory where all the Stardog databases and other files will be stored. If needed, you can change the default JVM memory settings for Stardog by setting the Stardog server Java args environment variable like so. This concludes the section about installation via Docker. This section is about installation on Windows. Stardog versions 7.3.0 and later can be installed using our Windows Installer beta release. First, download and unzip the installer zip file, navigate into the unzipped /bin subfolder, and copy the full path to that directory. Then open the Environment Variables editor from Control Panel, System, Advanced System Settings, then switch to the Advanced tab, and click Environment Variables. In the top section for User Variables, Select the path variable and click Edit and then New. Paste the directory path for the /bin subdirectory and click OK. Next, create a folder anywhere on your computer to be used as the location for Stardog database files and copy the full path to that directory. At the top of the environment variables window, click New to create a new user variable. Enter the variable name Stardog Home and paste the path to the new folder you created as the variable value. Click OK to add the variable, then close the environment variables and system properties windows. This concludes the section about installation on Windows. This section is about how to launch and manage Stardog. In macOS, Windows, or if you used Homebrew to install in Linux, use the following commands in a terminal or command prompt to manage Stardog server. To start the Stardog server, enter stardog-admin server start. To stop the server, enter stardog-admin server stop. On Linux, if you installed via a package manager other than Homebrew, Stardog will be configured to start on boot via systemd. It can be started, restarted, or stopped by the systemctl tool as shown below. To start the Stardog server, enter systemctl start stardog. To stop the server, enter systemctl stop stardog. And to restart the server, enter systemctl restart stardog. In Docker, because the stardog-admin server start command is the entry point for the Docker image, you must instruct Docker to mount a home directory with a valid license from your host machine at /var/opt/stardog in the image. In this example, Stardog Home is a Stardog home directory that only contains a Stardog license file. /var/opt/stardog is the location of Stardog Home in the Docker image. The contents of the release zip, binaries, docs, and helm charts, are located in /opt/stardog. To customize the environment in which Stardog is run, the file /etc/stardog.env.sh can be altered with key-value pairs, and we've shown an example here. By default, the Stardog home environment variable will be set to /var/opt/stardog, as shown above. This is the directory where all the Stardog databases and other files will be stored. You may change this environment variable. This concludes the section about how to launch and manage Stardog. This section is about how to launch Stardog Studio, which is an IDE for knowledge graph engineers that's also designed to make Stardog functionality easier to use for everyday users. Stardog Studio is opened in your web browser. First, start your Stardog server. In the browser, navigate to http://stardog.studio. Click Connect to Stardog at the top, and then to connect to your local server, click the tab for a new connection and press Connect, keeping all defaults. This concludes the section about launching Stardog Studio. In this training session, you learned how to install Stardog and Stardog Studio on several types of systems, including installation steps for macOS, Linux, Docker, and Windows. You also learned how to start Stardog and Stardog Studio after installation is complete. Thanks for following along. If you have any questions, please review our Frequently Asked Questions page or head to stardog.com/docs for additional information.